Hello, my name is Daniel Markwalter, and today we will be discussing the ways in which aging impacts identity and the concept of self. This topic is important to healthcare workers of all types because the perceptions of changing identity that occur in aging and dementia often concern patients and families greatly. Navigating these concerns requires thoughtful, compassionate, and nuanced care. In this talk, I will first present an overview of ethical considerations in the care of older adults. I will then review some of the underlying scientific concepts and clinical manifestations related to aging and the self. Next, I will focus more directly on the impacts of dementia on identity before transitioning into a discussion of the ethical implications of this subject for surrogate decision-making. Peter Rabens and Betty Black of Johns Hopkins University describe 10 topics warranting ethical concern that commonly arise in the care of older adults. These topics include the need to balance individual autonomy with increased dependence on family or group living settings, as well as safety and surrogate decision-making. As we will see, the concerns voiced by these 10 topics are heightened by the cognitive changes of aging. Identity, or sense of self, may be defined in a number of ways. Sometimes it is the particular role somebody plays, perhaps in the form of an occupation. But identity is also seen in the expression of personality, values, and judgment. All of these features of identity are dependent on cognitive processes such as memory, language, and executive function, and so that is where we will start. In normal aging, processing speed, attention for complex tasks, verbal fluency, and visuospatial function for complex tasks decline. But attention for simple tasks, language, and visuospatial function for simple tasks remain constant. Additionally, while recall of new information may be more difficult or slower with age, normal aging is not associated with gross deviations in memory. However, in some pathologic states of aging, such as Alzheimer's dementia, cognitive functions that are typically preserved with age may be lost. The biological mechanisms underlying this process are an area of intense research, but the pathologic markers of amyloid beta and tau protein are well established. It is hypothesized that the macrophages of the central nervous system, the microglia, may sense accumulating amyloid beta and initiate an acute inflammatory reaction in an attempt to restore tissue homeostasis. However, persistent inflammatory signaling may then lead to a state of chronic neuroinflammation that results in neuronal degeneration. Unfortunately, in addition to the well-known compromise in memory associated with Alzheimer's dementia, people frequently experience changes in their personality. Personality is intimately associated with the concept of self, and many families are troubled by the ways in which their loved one changes throughout the course of the disease. Common features include apathy, reduced concern for the feelings of others, and diminished emotional responsiveness. These changes in the features that comprise identity have led scientists and philosophers alike to consider the extent to which identity is preserved or lost in dementia. While the arguments are numerous, the conclusions generally fall into two groups. The first group argues that, at the very least, we pass through a series of identities as we age, but at the extreme, the person with dementia is necessarily distinct from the previously healthy individual. The second group argues that, no matter the extent of disease, individuals with dementia retain some features of their prior self, or at least a sense of self. In this way, a single identity is preserved across time. The most comprehensive research available on this debate is a systematic review of 33 studies, which suggested that perhaps the truth rests somewhere in the middle. The analysis concluded that, while varied in nature, there is evidence for the persistence of self in dementia as evidenced through the use of pronouns, verbalization of personal attributes, formation of identity and social interactions, and the utilization of nonverbal behaviors. On the other hand, certain important features of identity are diminished, including the possession of a coherent self-narrative, previously held roles, and self-recognition of personality. With this in mind, let us turn our attention to the ethical implications of changing identity in dementia, with a particular focus on surrogate decision-making. Broadly, a surrogate is necessary when a patient abdicates decision-making or when the patient lacks capacity. It is important to keep in mind that capacity may change with time and should be assessed on a decision-by-decision basis. Regardless, four criteria are necessary for capacity regarding a particular decision. The person must be able to communicate a choice, understand relevant information, reason about treatment options, and appreciate the situation and its consequences. As such, patients with dementia may lack capacity to make certain or all medical decisions. Patients with dementia may struggle to express a choice entirely or with consistency across time, Moreover, they may not understand relevant information, especially new content, have difficulty reasoning about treatment options, and fail to appreciate the consequences of decisions. When a surrogate is required, they are asked to make decisions on behalf of the patient using previously documented written wishes, such as an advance directive, and/or prior conversations with the individual. Surrogates attempt to act with substituted judgment, that is, use their knowledge of the patient's life and values to make the decision that they might in the situation. This framework is intended to safeguard patient autonomy, as prior wishes are assumed to reflect what a person believes to be their best interest in some future state of incapacity. However, many ethical conflicts, both large and small, arise because of two other assumptions in this framework. First, prior wishes, especially written statements, are assumed to represent a well-reasoned, informed decision, but such statements may in fact be based upon incomplete information. Moreover, patients may incorrectly envision one type of incapacity, for instance, nonverbal and emotionally labile states, but find themselves in another, such as a pleasantly demented and socially fulfilled state. In these instances, surrogates may find it difficult to apply the patient's prior wishes, such as a desire to forgo certain interventions. Phrased differently, individual interests may change as physical and mental states do, leaving surrogates and healthcare workers grappling with the task of balancing the autonomy of both the prior and current identities of the patient. As with many philosophical debates, a definitive answer is elusive, but we may make a number of conclusions. First, normal aging can be said to result in mild alterations to the idea of self, as roles and cognition change. On the other hand, dementia results in substantial changes to identity, perhaps with some identity preservation. Advance directives may help surrogates making decisions on behalf of patients with dementia because they are assumed to involve capacity at the time of completion. But this must be coupled with an awareness that surrogates may find it difficult to apply such wishes when the patient's interests appear to change. Recognizing this conflict will allow healthcare workers to more effectively guide surrogates in balancing the competing ethical responsibilities they have to their loved ones.